So last week at NAMM, I managed to visit the pro audio sector of the convention. It was at the Nord building at level 1. There were the likes of Amphion, API, ATC, BAE, Bee's Knees, Heritage Audio, Flock Audio, GIK Acoustics, Mag Audio, Manly, Mazelec, Neve, Rupert Neve Designs, Phoenix Audio, and as well as Sound Toys and Warm Audio. Yes, I'm reading off my iPad because I wanted to make sure that I mention all the brands that I managed to take a photo of during the walk around. So on the first day, I met up with Chris and Terry Morton from KickTone Microphones. They had quite an innovative product, which is a microphone that's quite versatile, mainly used for kick, obviously because it's in the name. However, I managed to meet up with them at their booth and they explained what the product was all about. I do apologize for the dropouts in audio from time to time. Apparently the convention floor was flooded with 2.4 gigahertz devices, but I tried my best to keep it to a minimum.
So hi, my name's Terry Morton and I am the owner of the Kickport microphone. So there you go, welcome to our booth. So first one I'll start with is our original product, which is the KickTone.
Okay.
So the KickTone is a dynamic mic. It's a dual concentric driver setup. So you've got two mics in there, a woofer and a high-end driver. Okay. The woofer is, you know, designed to capture low-end sub-frequencies like a sub-kick would. We use it on a bass, so you might want to get some
more
of the
definition,
more definition, as well as like the mylar of the kick, you know.
Or of the beater sound.
Exactly. You got it. So, with that said, the design has a case that allows the air to pass through the mic, hit the transducers, and then put out the back of the mic. Because what we're doing, we're actually connecting this mic onto a kick port. Here's the kick port, here's the connector.
Okay. Slides on.
Right over the top. There you go. Now you got it. Without it. So a pretty big difference there.
Yep. What also caught my eye at the convention was SHURE's new GLX-D Plus wireless system. Now, I'm a user of the old system, the GLX-D, and to be honest, I wasn't too happy with the performance, given that it wasn't that reliable, and also I was experiencing dropouts with the signal. When I spoke with the local dealer, Olympus Music, for SHURE, they also experienced the same thing. They had clients, returning clients, giving them this kind of feedback. So I was happy that they were offering a new and improved version, and this is what Paul from SHURE had to say about it. So we're here with Paul from the SHURE stand at NAMM. He's going to show us through the new GLX-D Plus system and what it can do.
This is the new GLX-D Plus dual band wireless system that operates in 2.4 and 5.8 gigahertz. Okay. So as you can see, this is a live spectrum analysis in this room. So you see how busy the 2.4 environment is versus the 5.8.
Okay.
And actually most of these spikes are our transmitters that are on right now.
Okay.
So if we didn't have our stuff on, then we just have this little thing right here.
So other transmitters are using the 5 gigahertz or 5.8?
Yeah, there's not a lot, as you can see. So there's tons of traffic here, very little traffic here, which is why we made the dual band system.
Okay.
You know, when we came out with the original GLX-D, 2.4 wasn't as crowded, but now everybody's making 2.4 and Bluetooth and all these things. And so it became a very crowded environment. So we developed the dual band system to give users the option, and so everything is automatic. So you turn on the system, it automatically scans 2.4 and 5.8, and it picks the best band, and then it lives there. It has a primary, and then it has backup frequencies. So if it detects any interference, it automatically switches. So there's no drop in signal. Even when you're getting interference on a particular channel, you won't actually hear it because of the backup channels and the frequency management that's happening.
So it's instant. It switches instantly.
Instant.
Okay.
Yeah.
I see we have the same features as the last one with the...
Yeah, so aesthetically it looks very similar, almost exactly like the old system.
Okay.
So we've still got the built-in chargers. The new batteries, so they're actually slightly larger than the old ones. But you can get 12 plus hours of continuous use out of the battery.
So the old ones won't fit in the new one, in the new charger. Okay.
I mean, they will, but they're going to be small, so it's not going to fit exactly. Yeah. So yeah. So the new system is not cross compatible with the old system. You can still use the antennas with the old system, but the frequency manager, the transmitters, and all the receivers are completely different, and so they're their own system.
Another booth that I really, really wanted to visit was the Mix with the Masters booth at the convention center. I'm a huge Mix with the Masters fan, and I'm a pro member, I'm a subscriber, and I follow them religiously. So when I got to know that there were talks by CLA, by Andrew Sheps, by Elangelo, and all these kind of guys, I checked the schedule and went for their talks. One of the talks that really caught my interest was the one by CLA, Chris Lord-Alge.
So great to see you all here today. How many of you are pro tours? Every single one of you? Okay, everyone? Okay. How many of you actually mix music? Wow, I thought it'd be all the hands. Okay. Okay, let me talk about, like, you wanna talk about mixing? You guys wanna hear about mixing or not? Okay. All right, here's how it works, okay? You're not a mixer until you mix every day. You're all recording engineers or producers or musicians, okay? If you call yourself a mixer, then you're not really doing the right justice to yourself. We're all engineers. You know what we get called mixers? Is when those artists want us just to mix their music, okay? When someone calls Lorenzo in the front row and says, hey Lorenzo, can you mix this record for me? After a few of those, you're a mixer because they want you to mix, okay? Because you mix some songs of your band or your friend's band or somebody else's, that's one thing. But when you're called out as a specialist, like Bob Clearmount was or I was back in the day, then you get that title of a mixer. I look at it as you're earning a badge, okay? Be humble. The more humble, the better. I'm just an engineer, I'm just a recording engineer. For some reason, mixing is just part of engineering, okay? When I started, back when it was 16 track, 24 track, shit before you guys knew, right? Shit you could do now, we couldn't do then, okay? Mixing was just what you did at the end of the day to make a cassette for the artist or reel to reel. So you had to mix it because they got to hear the song, so you had to mix it, rough mix it, whatever. So mixing is just part of engineering, I just want you to know that, okay? When you're humble and call yourself an engineer, and then when the charted records or gold records or stuff that does well starts to pile up, you can say, yeah, I do a little bit of mixing.
He also pulled up the session, the live performance from Elton John at the Dodger Stadium, and that was quite a treat to watch.
And that guy's crazy with the timpanis. Where are those things? Whoa, timpanis. You guys are crazy. Then the record company guy goes, oh, when does the freaking song start? Can you make a single out of this? Then he got fired. Any minute now. Oh, he's getting ready. Here we go. Okay. The
window that to our side. Everything about this house
right
out
of my mind.
Oh, it doesn't seem a year ago.
Guys, sing loud. Look, I cut away the leakage, right?
He said, sorry, honey, but don't change the pace.
He also replied to a very interesting question about mixing in Dolby Atmos during the Q&A session after his talk. And yeah, this is what went down.
What can you say with regards to new stuff that's coming out, Atmos, that's being talked about a lot right now? How does that translate live to studio, and where do you see those technologies going in the next little while?
You're just talking about Atmos versus stereo.
I am.
Well, let's make it simple. The question is, Christian's, they misspelled it.
But you thought my parents misspelled it.
Oh, okay, yeah, I know. Hey, don't run off just yet. I'm handing out gifts later. The question simple from Kristen is, what are you dealing with this new format like Atmos? Let's just focus on the format that matters. Fucking stereo, okay? Atmos is an afterthought that Apple first fed us with Dolby. I get it. It's immersive. Once you conquer stereo, Atmos is the next thing you can turn your stereo song into, okay? But the bottom line is that let's not forget about stereo and about regular stereo. And then Atmos is just the next level. Okay, once you've conquered it, get greatness going there, you can translate that greatness by your own means to immersive Atmos 360, whatever. But how does a company think? Let's just be honest about it. They come out with something that needs 13 speakers and God knows how many subwoofers. And they think it's going to be fucking great headphones. Who the fuck they think they are? Let's just be honest. If we could all put 13 speakers in our house and make it not be like an eyesore, and if we could all hear it the same way, it'd be just like stereo. Am I right or wrong? So don't think you're going to phase fuck me with some goddamn AirPod Maxes and tell me that's the miracle of science, because it's not.
I like that.
That's a good question.
So finally, after the talk by CLA, at the Mix with the Masters booth, I went straight to the SSL booth where they had a nice Origin console set up. And there was his brother, Tom Loldergi, giving a talk and also speaking about some sessions that he had worked on. I love the way he interacts with the audience. He seems like a very, very nice guy. He pulled up a Blink-182 session as well and he played it for us, which was nice. As well as the session from Yellow Card's Ocean Avenue.
My brother's up next. I'm Tom Lordowski. This is SSL Origin, winner of 2 tech awards this year. Thank you all. I really appreciate you guys.
So yeah, those were some snippets from the Pro Audio section last week. Stay tuned for more NAMM 2023 updates to come.
Bye, Felicia.